Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you BitBrowser, which is honestly one of the most impressive anti-detect browser I have tested recently. Now, if you have been struggling with managing multiple accounts across different platforms without getting banned, this video is going to be very helpful. So what exactly is an anti-detect browser? Well, imagine you are trying to run multiple Instagram accounts, Amazon seller accounts, or Google Ads campaigns. The problem is, these platforms can easily detect that you are using the same computer by looking at what is called your browser fingerprint. This fingerprint includes things like your IP address, screen resolutions, fonts, browser versions, and even your computer processes graphics. So BitBrowser solved this by creating completely separate browser profiles, each with its own unique fingerprint. So to these websites, each profile looks like a complete different person using a different computer, which is pretty clever, right? What makes BitBrowser special is that it serves over 3 million users worldwide and offers 10 free profiles completely, which is incredibly generous compared to other solutions. Plus, they support over 30 customizable settings to create authentic browser fingerprints, making it nearly impossible for platforms to detect you are using multiple accounts. Now, the use cases for this are really huge. Whether you are doing affiliate marketing, e-commerce, social media management, crypto trading, or running advertising campaigns, having multiple accounts is often essential for selling your business. But platforms like Facebook, Google, Amazon, and others are getting smarter at detecting and banning accounts that seem connected. So that's where BitBrowser comes in. It is not just about avoiding bans, it's about being able to work efficiently across multiple accounts without constantly logging in and out, clearing cookies, or worrying about cross-contamination between your accounts. And here's the thing. I have been using my referral link in the description, and you will get an extra 10% discount on any paid plans when you decide to upgrade. But honestly, start with the free version first, because those 10 free profiles might be all you need to get started. Alright, let's dive in. First, click the link I have put in the description and you will be landed on this page. This is the official homepage of BitBrowser, and here all you have to do is click on sign up now, and the sign up process is really straightforward. Just enter your email address, create a password, and verify your account. Once you are signed up, you will need to download the BitBrowser client. They have the version for Windows, Mac, and Linux, so choose the one that matches your operating system. Here I'm gonna download the Windows version. So after downloading and installing the software, just log in with your credentials. You will see a clean dashboard that shows your browser profile, phone profiles, and various other tools. And here's the interface. It's much more intuitive than most anti-detect browser I have used. Now let's create your first browser profile. So on the left section, select on browser profiles and click on add. Here I'm going to use Amazon as an example, since it's one of the most strict platforms when it comes to multiple accounts. Now first, under basic settings, give your profile a descriptive name. I will call this Amazon seller account 1. You can also create groups to organize your profiles better. Since this is for Amazon, I will create a group called e-commerce accounts. Now for the platform, select Amazon from the drop down menu. And if you don't find your preferred website, then you can select on custom platform and then just enter the URL of that platform. As Amazon is listed here, I'm gonna select Amazon. You can also set a specific username and password if you want, or leave it blank and log in manually later. Now after that, if you want to change some settings here, you can do that accordingly, but this is not that important. Also, if you want to enter any remark or enter any cookies, you can do that here as well. Now let's move on to the most important thing, which is setting up proxy configuration. So under the proxy section, select custom method. Now I'm using proxies from ProxySeller because they are honestly one of the best proxy providers I have found. I actually have a full review and tutorial about ProxySeller linked in the description. Plus there is a coupon code for extra discount. Now you will need to enter your proxy details. First, under lookup channel, you can select IP2 location. And under proxy type, you can select the type of proxy that actually you have bought. If you have bought HTTP proxy, you can select HTTP. And if you have bought SOX5 proxy, then you can select SOX5. Here, I'm gonna just select HTTP. Now, once you select that, under it, you will get two protocols, IPv4 or IPv6. So here you have to select the exact type of proxy that you have bought. Here I have bought IPv4 proxy. So I'm gonna keep it selected as IPv4. Now, importantly, from ProxySeller, you have to copy your IP address, port, username, and password. And you have to fill up all this important information accurately. And one important thing, write to username if you are buying from ProxySeller. Your username will be your login ID. So keep that in mind. So let me quickly fill up these proxy details. Now once you filled up your proxy details, make sure to test the proxy connection by clicking the test button. You should see a success message with correct IP location. Now once it is done, under preference, you can tweak and change all these settings according to your use cases. Here I recommend you to enable sync tab and sync cookies. And if you want to clear cache data before launch, you can toggle this on as well. Also, if you want to generate randomly fingerprint before launch, you can turn on this toggle. I just keep it default. And then if you want to enable GPU, you can turn off this toggle. And if you want to make your BitBrowser fast, then you can turn on memory saver. Now let's move on to the next important part, which is fingerprint. This is where BitBrowser really shines. Under fingerprint section, you can customize over 30 different parameters. At first, we need to select the browser. Here we get two options, BitBrowser and BitFox. For this profile, I'm gonna select BitBrowser. And under conversion, you have all these options. You can select any of these. I just want to keep it selected as default. You can select any of the latest version here as well. Now, after that, you can select the type of device. Here, make sure to select computer. And then under operating system, I will keep it as Windows, but you can change this. And for the OS version, I'm gonna select the latest version, which is Windows 11. And for the browser version, I'm gonna select the same as kernel version. And then under it, you can change the user agent if you want. Now for the language and time zone, I would highly recommend you to set this based on your proxy location for maximum authenticity. And for the window size, you can set the size of the browser profile when it opens. Just change the resolution here. And for the screen resolution, I would recommend to choose a common resolution like Full HD 9020x1080. Now next, for WebGL and Canvas, BitBrowser actually automatically generates unique values for each profile. And if you want to change unmaxed vendor, you can change it here as well. And for audio context, each profile gets a different audio fingerprint. And here also you can change the name of your device if you want. And here at the bottom, you can change the CPU core of your current browser environment. And also you can change the device memory. Now the beauty is that BitBrowser handles most of this automatically, but you have full control if you need to customize anything. And here even you can add browser extensions. For most users, the default settings work perfectly. So once everything is configured, at the bottom left, you can see if you want to generate random fingerprint for your profile, then you can just click on random fingerprint. But I don't want to do that as I already have changed some settings on my fingerprint. Now to save this profile, click on confirm at the bottom right and your profile will be created. Now here you can see at the top, our browser profile has been created. Now let's test our profile. So right here, let's click on open. Now as we are running this for first time, it's gonna take some time, so let's wait until it finishes the process. And there it is, BitBrowser has opened a completely isolated browser window. And here you can see that it shows our proxy's IP address and location, which is very accurate. And right to it, we have our destination website. Now here we can do anything on Amazon that we want. Now what's really cool is that you can have multiple profiles running simultaneously. Each one is completely isolated from the others. Different cookies, different addresses, different fingerprints. It's like having multiple computers without the hardware cost. Now before we wrap up, I want to quickly mention about BitBrowser's Cloud Phone feature, which is pretty innovative in Antidetect industry. Essentially, it's a virtual Android phone that runs in the cloud, allowing you to manage multiple mobile apps and accounts right from your computer. This is actually perfect for managing social media accounts that are primarily mobile focused, like TikTok, Instagram, or mobile games. Now, creating a phone profile on BitBrowser, it's pretty easy. First, you need to select the Android version, and then you have to enter the platform name, group, and if you want to add some remark, you can do that. And then you have to exactly enter your proxy configuration. And then under fingerprint, keep all these settings as default. And then just click on confirm. And the Cloud Phone profile will be created. Now let's open it. Now this profile will be opened within a minute. So let's just wait. And that is here our Cloud Phone has been opened. So let me show you by running the Chrome browser. Now here we can go over to any website and just start using this Android phone profile from our computer. And for BitBrowser Cloud Phone, the pricing start at just 0.03 cents for 24 hours, which is incredibly affordable for testing. You only pay when you actually use it, and you can have unlimited profiles. So as you can see, the combination of browser profiles and Cloud Phone profiles makes BitBrowser a complete solution for any business that needs to manage multiple accounts across both web and mobile platforms. Now let's talk about the pricing. BitBrowser actually starts at just $2 per month for additional users, and their browser profile plan are very competitive. Here you can see their pricing structure. First, they have a plan B. It gives you 50 profiles with 2 users, and it costs around $10 per month. And for plan C, it gives you 100 profiles with 4 users, and it will cost you around $15 per month, which is value for money. And then for plan D, it gives you 200 profiles with 8 users, and it costs around $25 per month. And then it scales up from there depending on your needs. Actually, compared to other Antidetect browsers, these prices are quite reasonable, especially considering you get 10 free profiles permanently. Now here are my honest recommendation. Just start with the free plan. Those 10 profiles are really enough for most small businesses or individual users to test everything out. If BitBrowser works well for your needs, I am confident it will, then consider upgrading to a paid plan. And remember to use my referral link in the description to get extra 10% discount on any paid plan. This will actually help support the channel and saves you money. So it's a win-win. Now that's it, that's the full review and tutorial for BitBrowser. BitBrowser actually has really impressed me with its user-friendly interface, robust fingerprinting technology, and generous free trial. And the fact that they serve over 3 million users and offer both browser and mobile account management makes them really stand out in the Antidetect browser space. If this video helped you understand BitBrowser better, please give it a like and consider subscribing for more tutorials on tools that can help grow your online business. And if you have any question about BitBrowser, don't hesitate to leave a comment. I would really like to help. And also don't forget to check out my ProxySeller review in the description for the best proxy solution to pair with BitBrowser. So thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.